Find the average rate of change of this function from x1 being 5 to x2 being 6. Okay, so when we're moving one increment to the right, how high up or down does it go? That's the average rate of change. The average rate of change is really the slope. And if you remember slopes of lines, it is the change in y, which is the rise, over the change in x, which is the run. Okay, so let's take all the numbers, let's plug them in here, and let's see what the average rate of change is. So I know what x1 is. X1 is 5. I know what x2 is. X2 is 6. I need to find the f of x1 and the f of x2. So let me come over here. Start with my original function. F of x is x squared plus 4x. And now, instead of x, let's find the f of x1. Okay, we know that given that x1 is 5, so let's find the f of 5. Well, that's going to be x squared plus 4x. Instead of x, we're going to plug in 5. And then 5 squared, 25, plus 4 times 5 is 20. 25 plus 20 is 45. So we found the f of x1, that's 45. Now let's find the f of x2. So the f of x2, we know from up here on the right that x2 is 6. So we're looking for the f of 6, and we're going to take that 6 and we're going to plug it in everywhere where we see an x in the original function. So x squared plus 4x. I want to put an x in there. I need to put a 6 in there. Let's plug in that 6. 6 squared plus 4 times 6. Alright, 6 squared is 36, plus 4 times 6 is 24, and 36 plus 24 is 60. Okay, so I have all four things to plug in now. Let's go ahead and do it. The average rate of change is going to be f of x2 minus f of x1. So that's 60. Minus 45, and it's all over x2 minus x1, which is 6 minus 5. Okay, so you see what I did there? That one there, that one there, this one here, and this one here. Okay, and let's see what that gives us. 60 minus 45 is 15 over 6 minus 5 is 1. Well, that's pretty nice. 15 over 1 is 15.